In this video, we'll be seeing about the indirect addressing. So in this, the effective address is nothing but which is present in another memory location. So for example, let us take this opcode. This is opcode and this is an instruction format where this is an opcode and this is representing some address memory location. Now, it will go and search in that. The data present here is not actual data. It is nothing but another memory location. So in order to get the data, first it has to move to this memory location where the memory location of another memory location is given and it has to go here. See like this. It has to go there in order to get the data. So for example, add R14001 means here it goes there. In 4001, there is a memory location, not the data. So it will go there and then 4005, there the actual data is there. Now this data is transferred to R1. This is an example for indirect addressing. Where in direct addressing, when the address is given here itself, so when you go there, go to that address, the data is present there itself. But in indirect addressing, this is not actually a data. Again, this is a memory location where you have to go to that particular memory location and get the data. So two memory location accesses that. This is called indirect addressing. So in this, the address will consist of the address where the effective address is stored in memory. So this slows down the execution as there is two memory locations. One time this and another one, again you are searching. Go for another memory location search. So there are two memory lookups to find the operand. So this is actually slow down the process because of the two memory location access. So how you can represent is accumulator equal to accumulator plus content, again the content of memory location. So add x will increment the value stored in the accumulator by the value stored at memory location specified by x. Now we'll see the next one. Register direct addressing. In this, the operand is contained in a register set. Instead of memory location, the operand is present in the operand will be a register set. So for example, no reference to memory is required. There is no reference of memory. All these are register set. B, C, D, H, L, like that. So add or will increment the value stored in the accumulator by the content of the register or. So for example, add B. When you give add B, it go and fetches the B register, the content of B registers, and it will be added with accumulator. See here, A is not explicitly given, but when you give add B, it will add the content of B register along with the accumulator value, and the data is stored back, result is stored in accumulator. Then move A comma B. Here also, both are registers. So this is another register direct addressing. So after execution of this, the content of B is moved to A. This is not actually. This is not A equal to. This equal to B. It's not addition. So after this, content of B is moved to A. Then INR A, increment A. That is, whatever may be the accumulator value, it will be incremented with the value of 1. So just one increment. You can see there is no memory location reference, all are registers. Then register indirect addressing. Here, the address field of the instruction refers to a CPU register here. That contains the effective address of the operand. So if you move here, it will consist of the memory location. So there is one memory location and one register reference. That's why it's called register indirect addressing. The data is not present here. It has to go and get this. It will be a memory address. So that go there, fetch the data from the memory location and do whatever is said in the opcode. So for example, here only one reference to memory location, unlike the indirect addressing where there are two memory locations reference, here only one memory locations and one register reference. So for example, add R1, then within bracket we give R2, which means it will increment the value stored in the accumulator by the content of memory location specified in R. That is this.